As I'm sure many of you have found, lockdown has been hard to remain social. My friends and I have been able to keep in relatively good contact, with regular Zoom quizzes, games, and even a video conference birthday. As it started to let up, those who live close to each other have been able to meet up a bit more. This trip, however, has been the first time we've all been able to get together for what feels like ages. After arriving, we got our camp ready, with 15 bed spaces between 9 of us, perhaps slight overkill. But then, some of us are old, and we like our luxury. This is our first camp as a group in a long time, for many of us, the first time to Bigbury. So I hope you enjoy this video as much as I did making it. As ever, first port of call is the beach, so with drinks charged, we made our way downhill to the sea.
Off to the beach.
You know, Tash.
We've got Cornel Stir back there. We've got Jack's on fire reaction.
With a clear evening ahead of us, we searched out what we hoped would be a beautiful sunset.
Faster!
Found the view we were looking for from the top of the lifeguard tower. And it's safe to say we were not disappointed.
Don't make it hit me.
Hard walk up from the beach. Sure be used to it
by the end of 4 days, but
it's hard.
Our evening walk complete, we settled into our first night, planning on a chilled one, ready for the next day. We woke early for breakfast and went back down to the beach. We'd started to see some reports of bad weather, but it was later. Nothing to worry about yet, we thought. Having scouted their route from the drone, James and Emma picked the tide and set out to paddle through a passage on the far side of Burgh Island. They had to be careful, too close to either side would see them dashed on the rocks.
Oh.
Once through, the danger wasn't over. The rising and falling of the waves could easily slam them down on the sharp shallows. As they paddled back, the waves were just starting to build with the wind. Sign of what's to come, perhaps. Back at the camp, the predicted weather rolled in. It got windy. Very windy. Maybe too windy. Luckily, Jack and I had had a quiet one the night before, so we were in no way hungover when dealing with this issue. We evacuated the tent and secured it to the fence. That's a problem for future me. Fortunately, the weather let up, and although it stayed windy, we got a break in the clouds. We packed and set off for Burgh Island. Having not been here before, I couldn't come all this way and not climb to the top. With the tide and weather on our side, it was now or never. The walk took us across cliff tops with unbelievable views. When camping on top of a hill, every direction is down. When the tide is in, a tractor can take you across. However, when the tide's out, it's just a short walk over the beach. Burgh Island has a rich history, with records dating back to the 1st century. Originally called St. Michael's Island, then later Burgh, and eventually shortened just to Burgh. During World War II, in fear that it would be used by German forces as a beachhead, pillboxes were constructed here on the top. James, ever the industrious mouse, insisted on a group photo, complete with over-the-top camera placement. From James, I expect nothing less. Nah, I guess it was worth it. Windswept, we retired to the pilchard for a well-earned pint. Overall, it was an absolutely fantastic trip. Broken tent aside, it was great to see everyone again and such a beautiful place to visit. I'm sure I will be back.